Your tunes all are like Indian, very melody. If you've been in India for some time more, you can know all the melodies of Narottam Thakur, Premananda, that all will be Shachi-putra-matra-swarupam Rupam tasya-vrja-uripurim Maturim-gostvatim Radha-kundam-girivarmaho Radhika-madhavasam Prato-yasya-prafita-kripaya Sri-guru-tang-natosmi Vanchakalpatarubhyasya Kripa-sindhu-dhyayi-vacha Patitanam-pavanetyo Vaishnavityo Namo-mahabhadannaya Krishna-prema-pradayate Krishna-ya-krishna-chaitanda-namne Gaurat-dise Gurave Gaura Chandraya Radhikayai Tadalaya Krishnaya Krishna Bhaktaya Tadabhaktaya Bhaktya Vihina Paradha Lakshay Chitvasya Samadhi Taranga Madhyay Kritamayin Tvang Saranam Prapanna Brinde Numaste Charanar Vindam Brinde Numaste Charanar Tavai Vashmi Tavai Vashmi Nadivami Dayadina Iti Vishnai Radhi Tangne Maam Chantam Come along with me in Varanasi Kashi on the bank of Ganges on Ashwamedh Ghat. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is sitting there. And Sanatan Goswami and Chandrasekhar and some of associates are there. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is giving teachings to answer to the question of Srila Sanatan Goswami. Who I am? Why I am so suffering? And I am suffering from the birth and death. I am drowning in the birth and in the ocean of birth and death. Old age and so many diseases, all things. How I can be happy? Three things. Three questions are related to three gyan. Sambandha gyan, abhidhya gyan, and prayojan. Prayojan tattva. Sambandha tattva, abhidhya tattva, and prayojan tattva. Who am I am? Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is telling. that, oh, now we are explaining the first note, Sanatana Goswami. So, I forget that. And we came to Vanas. Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami in Radha Damodar temple. There he is writing. Very solitary place. Very solitary place. It is in Seva Kunja. It is just a Siddha place. You know Siddha place?
Place of conception.
Because Krishna has played there. The feet dust of all the gopis, especially Srimati Radhika, is there. Especially Krishna used to come there and to suck Srimati Radhika, so it is Seva Kunja. Best place in Vrindavan. Bansivat and this place. Also there is a place Midhuban. Same thing. So here Krishna is controlled by Prem. Radha is also controlled by Prem. Here Prem becomes personified, like a person controlling Krishna. Srimati Radhika, gopis, all so we want Krishna Prem, not Krishna only. If there is no Prem, no affection and love for Krishna, then we will like Kamsa, Jarasandha, Shishupa, like demons. So, he has told first that here he is telling that Krishna is manifested in this world in six ways.
Six features.
Krishna himself, two kinds of guru, bhakta, avatar, prakash and shakti. First is he is explaining guru, bande guru, mantra guru arjata. I will try to explain it very shortly,
briefly,
because I will have to complete 3 and 4 chapters, most important. But this is background. Without this, we cannot explain all these things. And that is why Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has come to this world. Also, our bishopric orders, all acharya has come for this. Mantra guru are jato sikha guru gaun. Tahar charana aage kariye bandan. Mantra guru are sikha guru jato. Mantra guru means diksha guru. And Sikhya Guru, those who teach us how to serve Krishna. Who are you? What is bhakti? What is jiva tattva? And how a jiva, a soul, conditioned soul, can achieve bhava bhakti and from bhava bhakti to prema bhakti? Bhakti is one, prema bhakti, the service of Krishna. And Rupa Goswami has told it that anna abhilashita sunyam jnana karma then anukullena those who want to accept this bhakti, they should remember this slow first and repeat daily once. And try to go deep in this. and then practice. When we will begin practice, then it will be sadhana bhakti from your senses, your indriyas. And when a mood will come, then it will be bhavakti. And when we will have prem, then it will be prema bhakti. It is called sadhana bhakti, bhavakti and prema bhakti according to the stages of sadhaks. Understand? Sadhaks only. So, all are same. Those who give all this, really he is guru. Those who cannot give this thing, sadhana bhakti, bhavakti and prema bhakti, and they are not realized about all these things. They may do a guru work, but really they are not guru. Because it is very told in Srimad Bhagavat and all Upanishads everywhere. इसलिए गुरु के पास में जाओ तस्मा गुरु प्रपद्ये जिज्ञासु वेय उत्तम शब्दे परे च निष्णातम शब्दे निष्णातम परे निष्णातम च ब्रह्मन्युपशमः This is not this thing. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also supported this idea. Krishna also, all epics, Srimad Bhagavatam. Go to Guru, if you want to have really happiness, really bhakti to Krishna and realize Krishna. And who am I? How can I progress in this life? Then go to a very realized soul. Or he has some realization about this. And he will help you, surely. The symptom of that guru has been told that shabde cha pare cha. What is the meaning of shabde? He is perfect in Ved, Upanishad, Srimad Bhagavatam, all the books. But only with this will not do, whether he is perfect or not. But he has no realization of Krishna. Not doing so much bhajan. He is not so much progressed and realized in bhakti. Then he is not good. Even he knows all kinds of arguments and everything. So there are three symptoms of guru. Shabda brahma nishnat. He should know all the arguments of all the sastras. And secondly, he should be detached from worldly desires, material desires. These are two
external systems.
External system. And Swarup system, Swarup
internal.
That is Brahma Nishnatam. Pare. Pare who is Brahma? Pare from Brahma. Who is? Krishna himself.
Param Brahma.
Why Param Brahma? You taking this meaning? Oh Bhagyam, Nanda Gopa Prajau Kasam, Janamitram Paramanandam, Purna Brahma Sanatam. Krishna is Param Brahma, Purna Brahma, Sanatam Brahma. So he should have some realization, otherwise he will go down. He may fall if he has no relation. He was only knowing some arguments of the sort from books, but he has not done so much bhajan, and that is why they fell down. Even they know all the arguments, everything, sometimes practicing something, but not detachment of world, material things. And that is why the fellow. So we must go to the persons, devotees, who should not fail. Otherwise it will be very, very problem for us if Guru falls. Then our whole life becomes upset. So we should be very careful to this. So he is telling here, Mantra Guru ar jato siksha guru gan, tahan charan age kade bandhan. What he has written, Swamiji?
I first offer my respectful obeisances at the lotus feet of my initiating spiritual master and all my instructing spiritual masters.
Yes.
Purport. Srila Jiva Goswami, in his thesis Bhakti Sandarbha,
very carefully you should hear, very important in life.
Has stated that uncontaminated devotional service is the objective of pure Vaishnavas and that one has to execute such service in the association of other devotees. By associating with devotees of Lord Krishna, one develops a sense of Krishna consciousness and thus becomes inclined towards loving service of the Lord. This is the process of approaching devotional service, approaching the Supreme Lord by gradual appreciation of devotional service. If one desires unalloyed devotional service, one must associate with devotees.
Yes. Mark this line. If you want what?
Unalloyed
devotional service, you must meet
associate with Vaishnava.
And if you are not going, then what will be the result?
Asatsanga.
You will be in Asatsanga. So try to follow these lines of Swami. Some doubt that you are not in the line of Swami. But I think I am more in line of Swamiji. I am following all the totally words of Swamiji. Perhaps they are not following, and that is why I say that you are in not line of Swamiji. You should see. And you can judge yourself. Whether I am in line of Swamiji, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rupa Goswami or not, I am not going to tell anything against this. Totally I am giving to the whole world his message. This is message of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, our Upanuga, all Vaishnava. So we should very strongly and boldly try to follow these things. If he want unalloyed service of Krishna, devotional service, if he want. And if you don't, you want to make money, and see that, if I'm going to follow these lines, then my money problem will be. Come. And so I should not associate with good and high class of Vaishnava. And if you want, like Prahlad Maharaj, then you can mix it, associate with what Swamiji is telling. Again this line and go on. If
one desires unalloyed devotional service, one must associate with devotees of Sri Krishna.
Yes.
For by such association only can a conditioned soul achieve a taste for transcendental love and thus revive his eternal relationship with God in a specific manifestation and in terms of the specific transcendental mellow or rasa that one has eternally inherent in him.
If you will do like this, Krishna will manage everything for you. Don't fear. Krishna has given birth. He is controlling everything. So why we should fear for all these things? For these problems. All the problems will be solved by this. and then Krishna will manage everything. So be bold like this. And try to associate qualified Vaishnava. If you want unalloyed service of Krishna. Because not only then, three times it is handled, told. Sadhu Sangha. Again, Sadhu Sangha. Again, Sadhu Sangha. Sarva Siddhiya. What is the meaning? Unalloyed of service of Krishna can be attained by this. This is our first duty to follow all these things. Go on.
The secret is that one must submissively listen to those who know perfectly the science of God, and one must begin the mode of service regulated by the preceptor or teacher.
Yes.
A devotee already attracted by the name, form, qualities, etc. of the Supreme Lord may be directed to his specific manner of devotional service.
Hmm.
He need not waste time by approaching the Lord through logic.
Yes. Don't try to achieve Krishna by logic. Logic never cannot do. It is logic controlled by name or devotion. And if it is favorable to Shastra, like Bhagavatam or Chaitanya Charitamrita, then that logic can be some part taken. Otherwise, don't go towards logic. Go on.
The expert spiritual master knows well how to engage his disciples' energy in the transcendental loving service of the Lord, and thus he engages a devotee in a specific devotional service according to his special tendency.
One thing you should understand this. Then if a bona fide guru is there, all disciples will think that he loves much more me, other than anyone. This is the sign. This is a symptom of a all guru, all Vaishnavas, all disciples, all who are not disciples, coming in his touch, they will feel in their hearts that he loves much more me than anyone. We are seeing this thing in my Gurudev and also Swamiji. I think there are so many devotees of Swamiji. They can realize this. He used to
look after.
प्यार करना चाहता था आपको प्यार करता था. He always
was he loving you?
Loving you. So I think all will realize this fact that my Gurudev loves me much more than anyone. You are disciples of Prabhupada? Oh. You think?
Yes.
He was so much happy about your service? So this is the first thing. We have heard from the disciples of Srila Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Even a little boy, even a girl, innocent girl, anyone, those who were superior, all used to think that I am so much loving to my Gurudev. He loves much more. This is the thing. This is the actual symptom. Because he has no worldly gain at all from any his disciples. He wants to be his heart and Krishna into their heart. This is the thing. And if he is not perfect in the realization of Krishna prema, he cannot give these things. He cannot make sweet Krishna in our heart. Guru just never takes the heart of disciples for himself to gain it. He takes the hearts of all devotees, makes it so smooth, so soft, so fragrant, and so sweet. And he offers it to in the lotus feet are?
Divine couple.
Divine couple. Not directly. By giving them in his Gurudev's lotus feet and he to he and to he Param Gurudev, Paraspar Gurudev, and thus it will come in the lotus feet of Rukmanjari, and she will give him to Lalita Abhishaka, and they will offer him the lotus feet of Srimati Radhika. And Radhika will engage in the yogal service. So this is the symptom of Shiksha Guru and Vidya Guru both. Then go on.
A devotee must have only one...
If a guru is not doing like so, then you can pray him that please allow me that I should associate any good Vaishnava. His Gurudev will himself tell that I cannot satisfy you. You should go to Jiva Goswami. You should go to Rupa Goswami. You should go to Narottam Thakur.
Keshaji go Yama.
He will not invade. Invade
means? The envious.
He will not be envious. Oh, why you are going to that person? He will take you, but Jiva Goswami cannot do like this. Serve your Gurudev, come to me, and be more qualified to serve your Gurudev and Krishna. He wants no worldly gain at all. If he wants worldly gain, then he is not Guru. Truly. He will tell that, like Hridayananda of Kulin Gram to his disciple Shyamananda, that Goa comes to Vrindavan in Sevasana at the lotus feet of Jiva Goswami. He will make you qualify to serve Radha and Krishna. And Jiva Goswami did it. Actually, Jiva Goswami has no sister, but all world is his disciple. This is the symptom of the real Gurudev. Then,
a devotee must have only one initiating spiritual master, because in the scriptures, acceptance of more than one is always forbidden.
Yes.
There is no limit, however, to the number of instructing spiritual masters one may accept. Generally, a spiritual master who constantly instructs a disciple in spiritual science becomes his initiating spiritual master later on. One should always remember that a person who is reluctant to accept a spiritual master and be initiated is sure to be baffled in his endeavor to go back to Godhead.
What? Okay.
One should always remember that a person who is
reluctant
to accept a spiritual master and be initiated is sure to be baffled in his endeavor to go back to Godhead.
Yes.
One who is not properly initiated may present himself as a great devotee, but in fact, he is sure to encounter many stumbling blocks on his path of progress towards spiritual realization, with the result that he must continue his term of material existence without relief. Such a helpless person is compared to a ship without a rudder, for such a ship can never reach its destination. It is imperative, therefore, that one accept a spiritual master if he at all desires to gain the favor of the Lord. If there is no chance to serve him directly, a devotee should serve the spiritual master by remembering his instructions. There is no difference between his instructions and he himself. In his absence, therefore, his words of direction should be the pride of the disciple. If one thinks that he is above consulting anyone else, including a spiritual master, he is at once an offender at the lotus feet of the Lord. Such an offender can never go back to Godhead. It is imperative that a serious person accept a bona fide spiritual master in terms of the Shastric injunction. Srila Jivanamukta Swami advises that one not accept a spiritual master in terms of hereditary or customary social and ecclesiastical conventions. One should simply try to find a genuinely qualified spiritual master for actual advancement in spiritual understanding.
He is always following devotion. One thing I want to explain here that to have a guru like this, having all qualities, is very rare in this world. Very rare. But if we have some past impression, we have done some sukritis, and at that time we have, in lower stages we have some guru anyhow, not real guru, but yet some guru, Vaishnava guru, even a Kanishtha Adhikari, no harm. Then in that birth he has some impressions. So when he will come in this birth, then he will choose a very real guru. And how to choose? We should give up ourselves in the Lord's feet of Krishna and pray. Because he is Siksha Guru, inner guru. He will hear.
Chaitanya Guru.
Chaitanya Guru. Always hear. If you pray that, O Krishna, I want to serve you. Please give a good guru, qualified guru. Then Krishna will listen to it. And he will manage. And if you are not doing like so and managing yourself, that I will choose my guru, I will
pariksha,
I will examine my guru, then you will fall down. Bhakti is always sarva dharmana parityajyamam ekam sharanam aham tvam papibhyo mukti. If you will surrender without any worldly gain, sincerely, Krishna will surely arrange. So be like that. So everything depends on Krishna. Easily we can have that rare guru in this world. In this world, very rare guru. And more than that, very rare disciples are in this world. It is told in Shastra. Very rare devotees are. Disciples are in this world, who gave himself like Arjuna to Krishna. Like Krishna and Sudama gave everything in Shanavitini. Like Jiva Goswami gave himself in all respect to the Lord feet of Rupa. I think there are so many instances of guru and disciple in Vedas, Upanishad, Purans. But not like Rupa Goswami, Jiva Goswami, Sanatana Goswami. Who is the guru of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sanatana Goswami? And Rupa Goswami? He has written so many books. In all books he has in Mangalacharanam, he has prayer in the Lord's feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu as his guru. When Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave initiation to Rupa and Sanatana, where? fast sacrifice was done there? Mm-hmm. Any month he gave to them?
He inspired everything in their heart.
They adopted everything. Like Guru, this is the main thing. To whom? We follow. Internally, outwardly. And give easily, swabhavik rupse,
naturally.
Our heart in their protection. He is actually Guru. Whether he is initiated by that mantra or not, or fast sacrifice has been done or not. These are external things. So in Shastra, Jiva Goswami has told, he has not so much time to write all these things because Ramayana will come there, or Mahabharata, like Mahabharata so long. So he has not given all the examples. But it has, there are two kinds of disciples. Two kinds of diksha, initiation. Anusthaniki and Vidvat Rudi. Anusthaniki means only fire sacrifice has been done and Guru has told, oh, Gopijana Vallabhaya, Swaha, Om Bhur Bhuva, Prachodayat, he has to, and he thinks better. Oh, I should give so much donation to Gurudev, representation so much, fast sacrifice to done, my heart, my head has been
shaved.
And I am now Dikshit Vyakti. I have been initiated. This is outwardly. Not Vidvat Rudi Vyakti. When it will be Vidvat Rudi? When we will give our heart in the lotus feet of Gurudev, everything, and Gurudev will make me so qualified to serve Krishna. And Dibya Jnana. What is Dibya Jnana?
Divine knowledge.
What is divine knowledge? Who is Krishna? Who am I? What is Maya? Illusory Maya. Now if you see in here in this country or Western, all Western countries, that there is a very big problem between husband and wife. They are divorced so many times. They are very worried for their children. What to do? What to do? Very big problem. I pray you all that don't make this problem. Like Indian sister, if you are married once, you should be married for
whole life.
For little problems, you should not divorce each other. Don't be so much attached or don't so much detached. Try to do your kartavya.
Duty.
Duty only. That this is, she is my Krishna's servant, my servant, and servant. My boys or children are servant of Krishna. I should serve them. Only this. I should develop their Krishna consciousness. This is my duty. Don't be attached. So Guru gives all kinds of knowledge. Vidya Jnana. What is Maya? What is Krishna Tattva, Guru Tattva, Vaishnava Tattva, Prema Tattva? Everything. And how you should practice bhakti? How should we develop our affection, love for, unalloyed service of Krishna? This is Vidya Jnana. And Kuryat Papasya Sankshaya. Means? All sinful actions. What are sinful actions?
Prarabdha.
All kinds of worldly problems. too much attached in worldly affairs, having so many requirements, worldly requirements, having so much lust, so much anger, all these things. Bad activities we have done in past. And that are four kinds. What are four kinds? Prarabdha, aprarabdha, kut and avidya. All these. Avidya means to forget Krishna. And then everything, problems comes. So Gurudev destroys all these things. If he cannot do, then we should try to accept any siksha guru. More advanced. We should pray Krishna or Gurudev also. But Gurudev, these are my difficulties. So try to solve. If he is bona fide guru, he will tell, he will give advice that go to Rupa Goswami, go to Narottam Thakur, go to others who are advanced. And if that disciple goes there, to associate. If he envious,
yeah.
Then what to do? Then we will have to think that he should give up him or not. We should think. If he is against Vaishnavas and Krishna, all teachings, then we should give up. But not daily doing. Even in India, even a karmi does not give up his Gurudev for whole life. He thinks that he is God, he is Krishna. So we must treat like this. If your Guru is not so much, so high qualified, then taking permission, we can associate from higher rank of Guru. He will himself advise you to do. And if he does not do, then I think he deserves no quality of qualified Guru. He is telling now, Mantra Guru or Shiksha Guru. Tell me when it will be 25 minutes.
42 minutes has been passed.
42?
42 minutes.
It went down in a moment. One kirtan should be done to take me rest. And then I will. Anyone? You can you do any kirtan?
She's a professional.
Krishna Das. What kirtan?
I'm
Srila Krishnadas Goswami and attentively hear and try to follow. He is telling, Sri Rup Sanatana Bhatta Raghuna, Sri Jyugopal Bhatta, Das Raghuna, Echaya Guru Sikha Guru Jyama. He is praying first to his Sikha Guru. Why you can think about this? Also he has not named his Gurudev. He has told about Guru so many things. Shiksha Guru has taken the name of Shiksha Guru. So, Srila Rupa Goswami first, Sanatana Goswami, Jiva Goswami, Gopal Bhatta Goswami, Raghunath Bhatta Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, Shiksha Guru. He has taken directly Shiksha from them. And especially to both, whom? Rup and Raghunath. Because he will write in the last of each chapter. Why he could not name his Gurudev? Was any Gurudev Dikha Guru or not? I think it is impossible that he has no Dikha Guru. He has Dikha Guru. Some tell us that Srila Raghunath Bhatta was his Gurudev. But I have not seen any evidence in anywhere so authentic. If his Guru was what happened to tell? Nothing. I think it may be wrong or right, I cannot say, because anywhere it has not written. I have to conclusion that he and his brother in his life, in his grihastha, has been initiated by any Guru. No? That is, his name has been kept Krishnadas. Without any diksha, anyone cannot keep name like this, Krishnadas. But as a professional, he was Kaviraj. Kaviraj, Ayurvedic doctor. Very good. He used to know pulse. And also the pulse of the devotees for that disease also. So much good doctor. So there he has been initiated, but he left his brothers and everyone. And it seems that he has taken something side of his elder brother, perhaps. It may be not. And that is why he had not taken the name. or there may be some all other. But I think if he has made Shiksha Roop, like Roop Sanatan Jiva Ravana six things, realized soul, also associates of Krishna and also of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, like Roop Manjari, Kaun Sanatan Goswami?
Lavang
Manjari, Bhatta Raghunath Gun Manjari, Jeev Goswami Vilas Manjari, Gopal Bhatta Gun Manjari, Raghunath Das
Rati
Manjari. And in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu pastime, Se Rup Sanatan Bhatta Raghunath, Se Jeev Gopal Bhatta. There are two forms. No doubt they were eternal, S-E-S-S. If anyone is direct Shiksha Guru like this, why he will not be so one of his disciples? So he is proud of that. That Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, all are like this. Ta sabare charane mori koti namaskar. Innumerable dandva pranam in their lotus feet. And then he praying to bhakta. Like Srivas Pandit. Bhavane bhakta jato Srivasadi pradhan. Srivas is Narad. These are bhakta. Bhakta are of two kinds. Realized bhakta and sadhak bhakta. Narada in his first life he was sadhak bhakta. And after that he became a realized bhakta, premi bhakta. Here also he takes Sarva Damodar, Raya Ramananda, all the bhakta. Shikhi Maiti, Madhavi Devi, Sarvam Bhattacharya, all he takes. But prominent Shiksha Guru, six these, and all taking like Bhakta, because they have really some direct connection with six. Advaitacharya, Prabhu Ansavatar. Ansavatar mane?
Partial
incarnation of Krishna. Mahavishnu. Nityananda, Sarup Prakash, Vaibhav Prakash. Madhadhar Pandit, Madhadhar Pandit, Jagrananda Pandit, all are Shakti. Yes. Why Gadadhar Pandit was so generous, having no Bhamabhav? Bhamabhav, you know?
Leftic mood.
Always in submission to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Not in angry mood, that is man. To Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But Jagadananda has like this. Because Gadadhar Pandit was herself Paradita. And he was always working and looking after guarding Krishna, whether he is playing a good role of my part or not. Like a teacher.
From that.
So she is like that. Gadadhar Pandit. Always was. If he, Krishna tells anything,
then he
at once makes
reforms.
Like when Chaitanya Mahaprabhu met with Nityananda Prabhu in the house of Nandana Acharya, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was speaking and telling this slok. Varaha Piram Natavarabapu Karanayu Karanikaram Vibhatavasa Kamat Kapisam Vajayanti Chamala, physical group of Krishna. But he could not play the role of Radhika. Something like it. So behind Parda,
curtain.
He played a marvelous role of Srimati Radhika, Gadadhar Panti. Weeping loudly, tears coming, melting everyone. And he uttered this slok in so manner that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who was playing the part of Radhika, became careful and he followed him. And he thought that, oh, I've done here mistake. So Gadadhar Pandit is himself, Srimati Radhika, here playing a role of like a teacher here to teach Krishna his mode, because Krishna has taken his mode. Jagadananda? Like Saptabhama. You know all. He is also Shakti. He is praying to all Gadadhar Pandit. Krishna Das Kaviraj. Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu, Swami Bhagavan. He is Swami Bhagavan. Himself Krishna, Brijangalandan Shyam Sundar. Tahar Padar Binde Ananta Praman, Pranam. Sarvatman, Savarane Prabhu, Kariya Namaskar, Ehi Chaya Jeche, Kariya Vichar. I have told, Krishna Das Kaviraj and Goswami telling that, I have told briefly these six kinds of Krishna. Krishna himself, like six manifestations, himself Krishna. Yadyapi Amar Guru Chaitanya Radas. My Guru?
Servant of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Chaitanya, the servant of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But I know that he is himself Krishna. Sakshat Haripena. Samastasha. What is the meaning of Haripena? Can you define? Explain?
Guru is Bhagavan.
No.
Sakshat Hari.
He has not called Sakshat Hari, Haritvena. There is some deep meaning. He possesses the quality of Krishna, but not Krishna. So he is Das Bhagavan, Krishna Das Bhagavan. He has some qualities of Krishna, so merciful. He is the wholesome mercy of Krishna, Gurudev. So this is the quality of Krishna. So he possesses all these things, but not his Vishaya Krishna. If anyone thinks that Gurudev is also Krishna, like Vishaya Krishna, he is not right. So, we should know that he has the quality of Hari. That is Haritena Shakshal. Even Karmis, Jnani Tapasvi, they also think that Gurudev like Krishna. So we must know this. But we should not do Aarop. Aarop means?
Superimposition.
Impose.
To superimpose an idea that's not really
yes.
True.
This is mango tree. It will be fruit, mango fruit, and it will be dove sweet. This is arop, not real. If you are seeing any mango tree, and then I am telling that, oh, this is mango, and it will give fruit in time, then it is true.
Real.
But if we suppose unreal to be real, the fruit will be what? Not good. So we should know. We should not do arop. But in the beginning we'll have to arop. No way, other way. So that is called arop siddhartha. But we should arrope in Krishna to be Krishna. Like Krishna, deities are Krishna. We are now saying, doing like this, but actually deity is himself, Krishna. Understand? Deity is himself Krishna. But we are saying like a stone, like a statue. We cannot serve it like Krishna. But then our degree of affection will go up and we realize, then we see like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Shakshat Vrijendananda. Vigranahatumi.
Shakshat Vrijendananda.
Then it will become. Then it will be real. Guru Krishna Rupam Shastra Pramani. Guru Rupe Krishna Karen, Krita Karen Bhakta Vane. Shiksha Guru Kadayani, Ani Krishna Rastaru. I will explain it tomorrow. And after that I will take third and fourth. Very important all these things. I will explain who is Guru, who is Shiksha Guru, who is Diksha Guru. What are our duties to serve? How to serve him. So next day, we will explain all these things. Go Pramanam Dil.
I'm not going to do that.
Today is Ekadashi Vrata. I think that most of you have observed Ekadashi. To observe Ekadashi fully, like the king Ambarish Maharaj, is very rare. We should try. But we are Kali Yugi. He was in Satyayug. So he was so strong. he could have fasted till 1 year, he may, without sleep, standing on one leg, without water, without air he can. But he cannot. So Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came and mercifully he told that you can take something if you are so much hungry. You can take some fruits, some juice, milk, sugar candy, like this. But don't take again in minute and minute. Not that we took 1 kilo of juice, and after half an hour we took mango juice, 1 kilo. After that same half an hour we took so many boiled potato, so many with so many things. After half an hour again, so much water and so much pakodi. Oh, after that, chena, you know? Chin. About half a galo with so much sugar. You know, rabri? Then half kilo rabri. Oh, it is not a can see.
15.
Yes, no problem. To keep our life, we should take something so that sleepness, idleness and anything should not come. And we should try to not to sleep in night also, not in day and night, and also in night, chanting, remembering, associating, like
Ambarish Maharaj.
He was a householder person. He was the emperor of whole world. So much entangled in worldly things from outwardly we see. And we see in the other hand a Brahmin who was very realized yogi like Durvasa. If he tells anyone that he used to die, he will at once die. If a dead person is there, he will tell, oh, come on, come on. He can do anything. And also Brahman, Brahmarshi, Brahmavadi, or Vaidvadi he was at first. He was thinking that I have come in a Brahmin form and I am in the dynasty of Shankar. Shankar ka wo kya hai? Manifestation of Shankar. Son of Atri and
Anusya
Devi. Very learned and very good quality of bhakta. Uttam Mahabhagavat. Also the teacher of Sita Devi, hence of Lakshmi. And he was son. Think that I am greatest man in this world. I can do anything in a moment. But he did not use to observe Ekadashi. So when Ambarish Maharaj was there, in Mathura, observing Mahabhagavasi like this today, taking nothing, no water, no tea, nothing, observed himself in chanting, remembering, serving deities, praying, doing all these things, whole day, whole night. Next day, he has worshipped Krishna and he was ready to take some prasadam
as a
param. Next day. Same moment that Rishi, Durvasa Rishi came. He was like God. But not observing Ekadashi. He was realized Brahmavadi. He can't do anything. Ambarish Maharaj made him that you should take today Mahadvapsi Paran here and then I will take anything. Because yes, I am going to take bath in Jamuna very nearby. I am coming just now. But he delayed so much that the time of Paran was going on. Only 1, 2, 3 minutes was there. Ambarish was thinking what to do. In one hand, a Brahmin Rishi, not ordinary, he is Siddha Mahayogi, and he has come to my door. I should first
respect him
by giving Mahaprasadam, then I should take. If I am not doing, then I am disobeying Indian what?
Culture.
Culture. I said must obey. But by this, it may be that I may get to hell. But on the other hand, I have to object my Ekadashi. That is not a worldly thing. It is paramarthic. Paramarthic means?
Transcendental.
If I am losing, dishonoring Mahadvadashi, not taking in proper time something, Mahaprasadam, not serving, then I will lose my
bhakti,
devotion. I will lose. So, what to do? Honor to this Brahmin or honor to bhakti? He decided at last. I should honor bhakti. I cannot lose bhakti. I cannot do anything against bhakti. Whether I am losing anything, worldly thing. I am going to hell, no harm. But I should not disrespect it. So I must take something within time and observe Ekadashi fully. So he took some water. What water? Charanamritam of Krishna. He has worshipped with Tulsi. There was some water, Charanamrit of Krishna. He took only one drop of our water. If anyone has observed Ekadashi without any fruit, without juice, without water, next day he can take Paranam by that Charanamrit. But anyhow, one has taken fruit, juice and all, milk or anything. Or water even. He will have to take some grain, prasadam. Otherwise his Ekadashi is not full. So he thought that I have not taken anything, fasting, not taking water also, 24 hours. So I can take charanamrita and Ekadasi will be full. And in the meantime, the